Sakurajima is an active volcano in southern Japan. At present, there is no guaranteed way to predict when volcanoes might erupt, but new research by Hiroyuki Tanaka and Yukihiro Nomura from Muir Graphics and their team might change this. There are some physical indicators that a volcano could be ready to blow, but these cannot lead to accurate predictions. So Tanaka, Nomura, and their team decided to look in a new direction, upwards. Cosmic rays continuously bombard the Earth and create showers of tiny particles in the atmosphere called muons. These are heavy enough to penetrate through structures both man-made, such as the pyramids, and natural, like volcanoes. Specialized detectors made from thick layers of lead capture muons passing through large structures to create images called muograms. Think of it like an X-ray, but on a much, much larger scale. Several years ago, when Sakurajima was highly active, Tanaka and his team captured a muogram each day, exposed over 24-hour periods. These were fed into a special neural network originally made by the University of Tokyo Hospital for Medical Imaging. The researchers used the network to draw connections between periods of eruptions and certain features of the images that preceded those eruptions. This study only focused on Sakurajima, but the researchers are confident that with improved apparatus and more test data, their system could lead to an effective early warning system. Astronomy has come far since Galileo pointed his telescope at the stars. That telescope was essentially built from two magnifying glasses, originally made for seeing not the far away, but the very small. Since then, astronomers have often made use of tools from other fields to help further the exploration of space. Astronomer Yuki Okoda from the Department of Physics investigates protostars, young suns surrounded by matter which could grow into entire planetary systems. She and her team study the chemical signatures of these protostars, but the analysis required for this is an arduous and manual process which they wish to improve. They found a technique called Principal Component Analysis, or PCA, successfully extracts the specific data they want from the data their instruments actually collect. PCA is a more general purpose statistical tool to reduce the complexity of a set of data, and this is the first time it has been used for the molecular analysis of young stars. Okoda and her team hope PCA can be used on datasets from instruments such as the ALMA radio telescope in Chile to unlock more secrets from the cosmos. Have you ever had a go at woodwork? It can be rather tricky. Maria Larson from the User Interface Research Group and her team created an application to simplify the design and fabrication of functional wooden structures like furniture. It's called Sugite, the Japanese word for joinery. A simple interface lets users create digital designs for wooden joints. They can start from scratch or modify existing templates. Internally, Sugite models physical shapes with what are known as volumetric elements, or voxels, essentially 3D pixels. As users push and pull voxels to create the desired shape of a joint, the software automatically adjusts corresponding sections to ensure they will fit together. Its 3D view presents the virtual joint, and any potential problems with the design are highlighted in different colors so the user knows to correct them. Sugite also factors in the physical capabilities of the milling machines that will actually carve the user's designs from wood, so everything created should fit together nicely. Larson and her team hope that this kind of digital design philosophy could reduce wastage in the manufacturing industry. They also hope to scale this idea up to create larger structures and maybe even buildings.